Hello students, welcome all of you. In this video we have to derive Planck's law of black body radiation using Bose-Einstein statistics. A very important topic in statistical physics or statistical mechanics for BSc part 3 physics honors and MSc physics semester 3 courses. In lecture number 5 of statistical physics, this is an application of Bose-Einstein statistics to photons. Radiation from a black body at the absolute temperature capital T in thermal equilibrium with the walls of its enclosure, that is a black body chamber of volume V, is supposed to be consists of light particles or photons, each photon having energy equal to h nu, and they travel in all directions with the speed of light c. Photons are Bose particles or bosons having zero rest mass with a spin 1 and having two modes of propagation, that is photons having two independent directions of polarization. किसी ब्लैक बॉडी जिसका टेम्परेचर एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर कैपिटल टी है, जो अपने इंक्लोजर्स के वाल्स के साथ थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम में हो, वह ब्लैक बॉडी से इमिट होने वाला रेडिएशन फोटॉन्स से बना होता है. प्रत्येक फोटोन की एनर्जी एच न्यू होती है. एंड फोटॉन्स ऑल पॉसिबल डायरेक्शंस में ट्रेवल करते हैं. स्पीड ऑफ लाइट सी इज इक्वल टू 3×10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड के साथ. फोटोन्स बोस पार्टिकल्स हैं जिन्हें बोसोन्स कहा जाता है, जिनका रेस्ट मास, फोटोन्स का रेस्ट मास 0, स्पिन 1 होता है, तथा फोटोन्स का टू मोड्स ऑफ प्रोपेगेशन होता है. नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वांटम आइडिया, वॉल्यूम ऑफ एन अलाउड क्वांटम स्टेट और ए सेल इन द फेज स्पेस इज इक्वल टू एच क्यू. क्वांटम आइडिया के अनुसार प्रत्येक अलाउड आइजन स्टेट और सेल में, जो कि फेज स्पेस में सिचुएटेड हो, फेज स्पेस का ईच सेल और ईच क्वांटम स्टेट में का जो वॉल्यूम होता है वह वॉल्यूम इस सेल और इस क्वांटम स्टेट का वॉल्यूम फेज स्पेस में एच क्यू होता है, इज इक्वल टू एच क्यू अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वांटम आइडिया। अकॉर्डिंग टू हाइजनबर्ग्स अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल द एलिमेंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम इन द मोमेंटम स्पेस कैन बी रिटन एज सिग्मा पी इक्वल्स टू एच क्यू बाई वी। दिस इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ एन एलिमेंट इन द मोमेंटम स्पेस एंड इट इज रिटन एज सिग्मा सफिक्स में स्मॉल पी इक्वल्स टू एच क्यू बाई वी, वेयर एच क्यू इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ ईच क्वांटम स्टेट और ईच सेल इन द फेज स्पेस अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वांटम आइडिया वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। एंड वॉल्यूम ऑफ ईच एलिमेंट, वॉल्यूम ऑफ एन एलिमेंट इन द मोमेंटम स्पेस कैन बी रिटन एज सिग्मा पी इक्वल्स टू एच क्यू बाई वी अकॉर्डिंग टू हाइजनबर्ग्स अनसर्टेनिटी प्रिंसिपल, वेयर वी इज द वॉल्यूम, टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द इनक्लोजर ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी, दैट इज टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी चैम्बर इज कैपिटल वी। नाउ वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्फेरिकल सेल द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्फेरिकल सेल इन विच ऑल फोटोन्स लाई इन द आयन स्टेट्स ऑफ एन आर्बिट्ररी पोर्सन ऑफ द मोमेंटम स्पेस बिटवीन मोमेंटम रेंज पी स्मॉल पी एंड स्मॉल पी प्लस डी पी इजकल टू 4πp² dp। सो राइट डाउन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्फेरिकल सेल इन विच ऑल फोटॉन्स लाई in the momentum range p and p plus dp. So volume of the spherical cell in which all photons lie in an arbitrary portion of the momentum space in the momentum range p and p plus dp is equal to 4πp² multiplied by dp, where 4πp² is the area of the cell and dp is the thickness of the cell. So volume of that cell is of radius p and p plus of radii p and p plus dp can be written as 4πp² multiplied by dp. So volume of the spherical cell in which all photons lie in and in the आइजन स्टेट्स इन द आइजन स्टेट्स ऑफ एन आर्बिट्ररी इन एन आर्बिट्ररी पोर्शन ऑफ मोमेंटम स्पेस दैट इज आई एम रिपीटिंग अगेन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्फेरिकल सेल इन विच ऑल फोटोन्स लाई इन द आइजन स्टेट्स और सेल्स ऑफ एन आर्बिट्ररी पोर्शन ऑफ द मोमेंटम स्पेस बिटवीन द मोमेंटम रेंज between momentum range or momenta p a small p and p plus dp equals to area of the cell 4 pi p square into thickness of the cell, that is dp. So total number of ion states between momentum range p and p plus dp is given by, write down total, therefore total number of ion states or cells, ion states or cells in between momentum range or momenta p and p plus dp, momenta p and p plus dp is written as, or is given by, we can write total number of states as total number of ion states or cells between momenta p, a small p, and p plus dp. That is momentum range a small p and p plus small p plus dp is given by gp dp. G, function of g under bracket p, that is function of momentum. G under bracket a small p dp equals to 4 pi p square dp, that is volume of the spherical cell, upon h cube by v, that is volume of an element, that is an element of volume in the phase space, in the momentum a space is sigma p is equal to h cube upon v. So h cube by v is the an element of volume in the momentum of space, which is h cube upon v, where h is Planck's constant and v is the total volume of the enclosure. So total number of ion states between momenta or momentum range a small p and p plus a small p plus dp is g, a small g under bracket p, that is g is the function of p, that is gp dp is the total number of ion states, is equal to 4 pi p square multiplied by dp upon h cube upon v. And suppose it is equation number 1. For a photon, the energy of photon we know E is equal to h nu, and it is equal to nu is equal to c upon lambda. C is the wavelength of the photon, c is the speed of light or photon, and lambda is the wavelength of photon. So nu is equal to c by lambda, and energy of a photon is E is equal to capital E is equal to h nu, whatever hai, is equal to hc by lambda. Nu is equal to frequency of the photon is a speed of light upon wavelength of photon, sc by lambda. So we can write it as dp. This is equal to this is energy, and h nu is sc by lambda. Therefore using the de Broglie relation, momentum of the photon is p is equal to h by lambda, h upon lambda, and we can write h upon lambda, and c is equal to nu lambda. Therefore c is equal to nu lambda, therefore lambda is equal to c by nu. In place of lambda we can write c by nu, so c upon nu. So finally it is h nu upon c is equal to h nu upon c. So momentum of a photon is a small p is equal to h by lambda using the de Broglie relation, and it's equal to h upon lambda, and lambda is c upon nu, and finally it is h nu upon c. Nu numerator mein chala jayega, denominator mein c hoga, speed of light, nu frequency of photon hai. Therefore differentiating it, p is equal to h nu by c. Therefore momentum of a photon, therefore dp is equal to h d nu upon c, that is dp is equal to h by c into d nu after differentiating it. So p is equal to h nu by c, therefore dp is equal to h d nu upon C. So substituting these values in equation 1, we can write, so equation 1 becomes, substituting these value in equation 1, we have substituting these values in equation 1, we have g nu d nu, gp dp can be written as now g nu function of frequency g nu d nu equals to 4 pi v numerator में चला जाएगा एच क्यू बाई वी इक्वेशन वन में जी पी डी पी इजकल टू 4 पाई पी स्क्वायर डी पी अपॉन एच क्यू बाई वी देयर फोर वी कैन राइट इट एज 4 पाई कैपिटल वी पी स्क्वायर डी पी अपॉन एच क्यू सो इट इज 4 पाई वी अपॉन एच क्यू इन प्लेस ऑफ पी वी कैन राइट मोमेंटम ऑफ ए फोटोन एच न्यू बाई सी स्क्वायर दैट इज एच स्क्वायर न्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन सी स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाइड बाई डी पी इज एच एच डी न्यू अपॉन सी एच बाई सी इंटू डी न्यू एच बाई सी इंटू डी न्यू एंड ना इट इज नाउ दिस कैन बी रिटन एज जी न्यू डी न्यू इजकल टू 4 पाई वी अपॉन एच एच क्यू एच स्क्वायर इंटू एच इन द न्यूमरेटर एच स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाइड बाई एच इज एच क्यू एंड इन द न्यूमरेटर देर इज ऑल्सो एच क्यू सो एच क्यू will cancel out in the numerator and denominator and so we have 4 pi v upon c square into c that is cq nu square d nu so we have now we have g nu d nu equals to we have now we can write G total number of eigenstates G nu D nu equals to we have left with 4 pi capital V upon in the denominator C square multiplied by C that is CQ multiplied by nu square D nu and this is suppose it is equation number 2 so now total number of eigenstates between the frequency range now between the not in momentum range not momentum range p and p plus dp now in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is total number of eigenstates in the frequency range g nu in the frequency range sorry nu and nu plus d nu is g nu d nu g under bracket nu d nu equals to 4 pi v upon cq nu square d nu. Now there is a duplication of states for two independent directions of polarization of the photons. We have already discussed initially in this video. So ki photon ka two independent directions of propagation hota hai. So isliye there is a duplication of a state, so we have to multiply this factor that is RHS in equation 2 by 2, factor 2, so it will be g nu will be equal to 2 multiplied by 4 pi v upon cq multiplied by nu square d nu. Chuki photon ka two independent directions direction of propagation possible hai, to isliye and a photon having two independent directions of polarization. Photons having two independent directions of polarization. So, or we can say that photons having two modes of propagation. So, we have to multiply RHS of equation 2 by factor 2. So, it will be total number of eigenstates in the frequency range. Frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is g nu d nu equals to 2 multiplied by 4 pi v upon cq into nu square d nu for photons having two modes of propagation. that is two independent directions of polarization of photons. It's equal to 2 into 4 pi v upon c q into nu square d nu, that is 2 into 4 pi v is 8 pi v. V is the total volume of the enclosure upon c, 8 pi v upon c q multiplied by nu square d nu due to bracket mein aap likh sakte hain due to 2 two modes of propagation of photons, so total number of eigenstates between the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is g nu, g under bracket nu d nu equals to 8 pi v upon c q multiplied by nu square into d nu. Now using this result, suppose it is equation number 3. So using this result in Bose-Einstein distribution law, which is Ni equals to Gi upon e to the power alpha plus beta e minus Ni is equal to Gi upon a small e exponential alpha plus beta ei minus 1. So using this relation in Bose-Einstein distribution law, we can write dn is equal to g nu d nu, that is total number of the eigenstates in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta e is the energy of a photon which is equal to h nu minus 1. तो अभी इस रिजल्ट को हम Bose-Einstein डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लॉ में यूज करेंगे. सो वी हैव राइट डाउन यूजिंग दिस रिजल्ट और दिस रिलेशन, दैट इज इक्वेशन नंबर 3, यूजिंग दिस रिजल्ट और दिस इक्वेशन, दिस रिलेशन गिवन बाय इक्वेशन 3, दिस रिजल्ट in Bose-Einstein distribution law, we have dn equals to Bose-Einstein distribution law, dn is equal to g nu d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta into e minus 1. Now g nu d nu is 8 pi v upon c q nu square d nu. So we have to write equals to 8 pi v upon c q multiplied by nu square d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta e minus 1. Now we can write dn upon v, that is number of photons per unit volume lying in the frequency range nu and nu plus dv, and sorry nu and nu plus d nu. So dn mein LHS mein jo dn hai usme agar hum v se divide kar diya jaye, yani dono side mein is equation ke both sides mein v se divide kar diya jaye, to LHS में dn by v होगा और RHS में 8 pi v से v कैंसिल हो जाएगा, तो 8 pi by c cube nu square d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta e minus 1. तो suppose it is equation number 4 and dividing both sides by capital V, that is volume of the enclosure of the black body, that is black body chamber, volume of a black body chamber. So it is now dn by v, which gives the total number of photons lie between the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. So this is number of photons per unit volume lie between the frequency range nu and nu plus डी न्यू इज डी एन वाई भी इक्वल्स टू एट पाई अपॉन सी क्यू मल्टीप्लाइड बाई न्यू स्क्वायर डी न्यू अपॉन ई टू द पावर अल्फा प्लस बीटा ई स्मॉल ई दैट इज एक्सपोनेंशियल पावर अल्फा प्लस बीटा ई माइनस वन एंड सपोज इट इज इक्वेशन नंबर 5 डी एन अपॉन भी इक्वल्स टू 8 पाई बाई सी क्यू न्यू स्क्वायर डी न्यू अपॉन ई टू द पावर अल्फा प्लस बीटा ई कैपिटल ई विच इज द एनर्जी ऑफ ए फोटोन माइनस वन एंड से इट इज इक्वेशन नंबर 5 इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई बोथ साइड्स बाई एच न्यू देन वी हैव एनर्जी डेंसिटी ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज न्यू एंड न्यू प्लस डी न्यू वी विल ऑब्टेन एनर्जी डेंसिटी ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज न्यू एंड न्यू प्लस डी न्यू इफ वी मल्टीप्लाइड बोथ साइड्स ऑफ इक्वेशन 5 बाई एच न्यू दैट इज एनर्जी ऑफ द फोटोन सो मल्टीप्लाइंग बोथ साइड्स बाई एच न्यू दैट इज एनर्जी ऑफ फोटोन वी हैव Now, dn by we have dn upon v multiplied by h nu in LHS and in RHS it is in RHS we will also multiply by h nu so it will be h 8 pi h nu square into nu that is nu q 8 pi h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta e is the energy of the photon capital E minus 1 and this gives the energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu and which can be represented by the symbol capital U nu in suffix d nu U nu d nu capital U suffix mein nu d nu is the energy density of black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu that is this term is U nu d nu this term dn upon v this term in LHS that is dn upon v number of photons per unit volume multiplied by h nu energy of a photon this is energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu and it can be written as u nu d nu so it is dn upon v into h nu is capital u nu in suffix d nu u nu d nu equals to dn upon v multiplied by h nu or dn upon v multiplied by h nu is represented by u nu d nu which is the energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu and this is Planck's law of black body radiation so finally we can write the relation we have obtained that is u nu d nu in place of dn by v multiplied by h nu in LHS of the equation LHS of the last equation that is dn upon v multiplied by h nu is capital u nu d nu and in RHS it is 8 pi a small h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon e to the power alpha plus beta e minus 1 so from this relation we will obtain Planck's law of black body radiation after putting alpha is equal to 0 and beta is equal to 1 by kt and e is equal to h nu so u nu d nu equals to 8 pi h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon e to the power, putting alpha is equal to 0 in this equation. Suppose it is equation, last equation is equation number 6, which is u nu d nu. U nu d nu, that is energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन का एनर्जी डेंसिटी है फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज न्यू एंड न्यू प्लस डी न्यू में. सो द फाइनल इक्वेशन वी हैव नाउ पुटिंग अल्फा इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड बीटा इज इक्वल टू 1/kT एंड कैपिटल इज इक्वल टू एनर्जी ऑफ ए फोटोन इज इक्वल टू एच न्यू. इन इक्वेशन 6 वी गेट द प्लैंक्स लॉ ऑफ ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन. सो वी हैव u nu d nu is equal to 8 pi h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon e to the power h nu by e to the power exponential h power e to the power h nu upon kt minus 1. And this is the final expression, equation 7. After putting alpha is equal to 0, alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to 1/kT. After putting alpha is equal to 0, beta equals to 1/kT. And E is equal to H nu, that is energy of a photon. Capital K is Boltzmann constant. Boltzmann's constant, T is the, capital T is the, capital K, K is the Boltzmann's constant and capital T is the absolute temperature. And capital E is the energy of the photon. So putting alpha is equal to 0, beta is equal to 1/kT, and E is equal to H nu in the denominator of RHS of equation 6, we have obtained U nu D nu, that is energy density of the black body radiation. U nu D nu is the energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. So energy density of the black body radiation in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is denoted by the symbol capital U nu in suffix d nu equals to 8 pi h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon e to the power h nu upon kt minus 1. And this is Planck's law of black body radiation. So we have derived Planck's law of black body radiation, which is given by u nu d nu is equal to 8 pi h nu q upon c q multiplied by d nu upon h upon e to the power exponential, that is exponential e to the power h nu upon kt minus 1. And this is Planck's law of black body radiation. Write down this equation, that is equation 7 represents Planck's law of black body radiation. This is the Planck's law of black body radiation. Now this video is completed. Thanks all of you for watching my YouTube channel, Physics Quantum Classes.